Hi students, welcome to Gauri Smart Channel. Today we are going to discuss about trigonometry chapter. Most very important, definitely 5 or more than 5 marks will be coming in IIIT. So definitely you will get. But so many students are feeling very difficulty this chapter because of this is the new chapter which is introducing in our 10th class. So if you see the full video, definitely I am saying you will not have any fear about this chapter. So that much of easiness I am going to say. So now listen the trigonometry. So before going to start the trigonometry chapter, first we have to do one like. So give a like. Now I will start. Trigonometric concept. So here the name itself, three means three. Tri means three. Gona means angle. Gona means angle. Metri means measure. Metri means measurement or measure. So the three angle measurement is called trigonometry. The three angle measurement is called trigonometry. See these three angles where it will be. These three angles will be in triangle. So in a triangle, the study of angles is called trigonometry. The relation between angles and sides is called trigonometry. This trigonometry is introduced by Hipparchus. So he is a Hipparchus. The father of trigonometry is Hipparchus. Now, three angle measurement is called trigonometry. So we have to know the what is meant by angle. See here point is there. And one more point is there. So if you join these two points, you will get line segment. And if you extend one point infinitely into one side, that is called ray. And one more ray I am taking. So these two ray are coincidence with each other. If another ray is moving somewhat distance and one ray is fixed ray, then the union of these two rays is called angle. Two rays which are having same initial point, two rays which are having same initial point, then the union of two rays is called, or the gap between two rays is called angle. So here A, here O and here B, then this is called theta. So angle is represented by angle AOB or angle BOA, that is equal to theta or simply angle O, we can say like that. Now types of the angles. So we know already very well types of the angles: zero angle, acute angle, right angle, obtuse angle, straight angle, reflex angle, complete angle. Like this, several angles are there. Those are all known it. But we have to know here complementary angles and supplementary angles. Complementary angles and supplementary angles. What are complementary and what are supplementary? So complementary angles and supplementary angles. So complementary angles means the sum of two angles is 90 degrees, then those are called complementary angles. So angle A plus angle B is equal to 90 degrees, then the A and B are called complementary angles. The sum of two angles is 180 degrees, the sum of two angles is 180 degrees, then the two angles are called supplementary angles. Then the two angles are called supplementary angles. And also we should know the quadrant angles. Quadrant angles means 90, 180, 270, 360. So that means this is called rotating ray and this is called fixed ray. So the rotating ray with coincide with axis of the coordinates, then the angles formed are called coordinate angles. Quadrant angles are 90 degrees, 180 degrees, 270 degrees and 360 degrees. So these are the types of the angles. This is the angle. Now this measurement is also very very important. So I am going to say the measurement. So angle you know very well. Now types. The measurement of angles is of three types. Most very important, the measurement of angles. Measurement of angles is three types. The first one is sexagesimal system. Sexagesimal system or British system. So what is this sexagesimal system or British system? Let us consider. See here one ray is there and here also one more ray is there. These two are coincident with each other. Then if the ray is moving and it is passing through light and it is moving up to complete one angle, then that is called complete degree. So complete angle. So this complete angle 360 degrees is divided into 360 equal parts. This complete angle 360 degrees is divided into 360 equal parts. Then each part is called one angle, 1 degree. Then each part is called 1 degree. So this is called sexagesimal system. So if 360 degrees is divided by equally 360 parts, then the system is called sexagesimal system or British system. In this British system, we can say that each part is called 1 degree. Each part is called 1 degree. And also this 1 degree, if you divide into 60 equal parts, this 1 degree, if you divide into 60 equal parts, then each part is called 1 minute. So this means this is 60 minutes. And again, 1 minute, if you divide into 60 equal parts, then each part is called 60 seconds. So this is the degree symbol, this is the minute symbol, this is the second symbol. So like that you have to remember. So British system or sexagesimal system is nothing but 360 degrees is equally divided into 360 parts, then each part is called degree, and each degree is again divided into 60 equal parts, then each part is called minute, and again each minute is divided into 60 equal parts, then each minute is called, and that is called 1 second. So each one is called 1 second. So these are the types in a British system. Now we are going to discuss about centesimal system. Centesimal system means, we know very well right angle. So right angle 90 degrees will be there. If the 90 degrees is centi means what? 100. Centi means what? 100. If the right angle is divided into 100 equal parts, if the right angle is divided into 100 equal parts, then each part is called 1 grade. So that means 100 degrees is equal to 90 degrees is equal to 100 grades. So if the right angle is divided into 100 equal parts, then each part is called 1 grade. This system is called a centesimal system because we are dividing 90 degrees into 100 equal parts. So that's why this is called centesimal system. So here 90 degrees is equal to 100 grades. So 1 degree is equal to 100 by 90 grade. So 0, 0 cancel, then we can say 10 by 9 grades. Next, circular system. Next, we have to know the circular system. So circular system means, in a circle, so if you take a radius and arc, circle, the length of the arc, an angle which is subtended by an arc which is equal to the radius of the circle, then it is called 1 radian. Once again I'm saying, in a circle, angle subtended by arc of the circle, an angle subtended at the center by arc of the circle, which is equal to the length of the arc, then it is called 1 radian. So this is called radian system, and also we can say that circular system. So here we can say that this is total 2 pi r. So this 2 pi r is, we know very well, that is 360 degrees, because so complete angle. So here we have to take 1 radian, means r value should be unit radian. Unit radian means 2 pi radian, because just now we got radian. It is a definition as radian. So 2 pi radian is equal to 360 degrees. So pi radian is equal to 360 by 2. So 2 ones are 2, 180 is are. So that means pi radian is equal to 180 degrees. So this is the relation between radians and degrees. Now the relation between this hexagesimal system and centesimal system and circular system, one formula is there. That is the relation I am going to show you. That is, see here, hexagesimal system, that is degrees, and here centesimal system, that is c, and radian system is, that is r. So let us consider. So d by 90 degrees is equal to c by British system 100 grays. So 100 grays, that is equal to 2 pi by 2 radian. So this is the relation between sexagesimal system and centesimal system and circular system. So this is the most very important relations which is going to be asked in an exam. Okay, now we are going to discuss about ratio. So what is mean by ratio? A quantity which is divided by another quantity, that is called ratio. A quantity divided by another quantity, that is called ratio. For example, if you say A by B, means the quantity A is divided by quantity B. So this is called ratio. Now we have to learn about trigonometric ratios. How to define trigonometric ratios? Let us see how to define trigonometric ratios. See here, this is x axis and y axis. So this is the origin. Now I am considering from the origin a radius r. Radius r I am considering. Using this is the center and this is a radius, I am drawing a circle. So now if I draw a circle, here P point is on the circle. Using this P point, if I draw a perpendicular on x-axis, then it meets the x-axis at M. Then we know very well this is a perpendicular distance which is parallel to y-axis, so it is y distance, and it is a x distance. So this is a x. And this radius is making an angle with positive direction of x-axis, that is theta. So once again, I'm repeating. In a plane, x-axis and y-axis I'm taking. The origin is the center. So using origin, I'm taking some radius r. So using this radius and r, radius and center, I'm drawing a circle. So which is meeting at P. Then I'm drawing the perpendicular to the x-axis at M. Then this is the x distance, this is the y distance, and this is the radius r. So using this triangle, so I know very well, we know very well, you know very well, the relation between angles and sides in a triangle is called trigonometry. So trigonometric ratios, those only trigonometric ratios. Just now we discussed the ratios, that is A by B. So here we are discussing trigonometric ratios. Now see here, this is the opposite side to the theta, because this is the opposite. Next, this is the side which is beside the triangle, beside the angle. So means this is the adjacent angle, because beside only it is there. The side is beside to the theta, so it is the adjacent side to the theta. And we know this is a hypotenuse, because 90 degrees opposite side. So the side which is opposite to 90 degrees, that is called hypotenuse. Now using this triangle, we know very well opposite side by hypotenuse. The ratio of the opposite side and hypotenuse is defined as sine to the theta. So we can say that, so sine theta is equal to y by r. Now one more ratio I am taking, that is adjacent side by hypotenuse. So now just now I have taken this side by this side, opposite side by hypotenuse. Now I am going to take adjacent side by hypotenuse, means x by r. This is defined as cos theta, because cos of theta, so cos theta. Now this by this and this by this I am taking. Now I am going to take this by this, means y by x, that is equal to tan theta. So the ratio of opposite side to the adjacent side, that is called tan theta. Now clearly if you observe, this by this I am taking. Now I'm going to take opposite, means hypotenuse by adjacent side, that is r by y. We take, then that is cosecant theta. Now this reciprocal I am going to take, that is r by x, then that is secant theta. Now this reciprocal I am going to take, that is x by y, that is cot theta. So if you understand this 6 trigonometric ratio, then trigonometry is very easy. How these ratios are coming, if you learn, then this is a very easy chapter. So simply opposite side by hypotenuse is sine theta, adjacent side by opposite hypotenuse is cos theta. Like that, if you mug up, means it is not coming to you, because we have to learn through concept. Now using this concept, I know very well opposite side by adjacent side. So okay, opposite side. So that is y by x. Y by x means tan theta. So using concept only we should get. So now you understand, I think. Now we are going to discuss about next concept. That is relations. Relations means reciprocals. See here, If any two numbers are multiplying, then we are getting one. Then the two numbers are called reciprocals to each other. Reciprocals to each other. For example, 3/5 I am taking into 5/3. So I am getting 3 1s are 3 1s are 5 1s are 5 1s are. So 1 I am getting. So here 3/5 is the reciprocal of 5/3, and 5/3 is the reciprocal of 3/5. So this concept only we are introducing in trigonometric. So if you know this small concept, it is very easy. Now you will learn. See here very easily. A means I am taking sine theta. B means I am taking cosecant theta. Cosecant theta. Now here see, sine theta means what? Y by r. Cosecant theta means what? R by y. So y and y will get cancelled. R and r will get cancelled. One I am getting. So a into b is equal to 1 means a comma b are reciprocals to each other. Sine theta into cosecant theta is equal to 1 means sine theta and cosecant theta are reciprocals to each other. Reciprocals to each other. Now using this formula, a can be written as 1/b and b can be written as 1/a. So this is the small basic concept, because these two are multiplying. If you bring this term to that side, it is dividing. If you bring this term also, that is dividing. So same concept here also. See here, sine theta is equal to 1/cosecant theta. Sine theta is equal to 1/cosecant theta, and cosecant theta is equal to 1/sin theta. Sine theta is equal to 1/cosecant theta, and cosecant theta is equal to 1/sin theta. Now, so this is the small concept we are learning. So this is the one formula, this is the one formula, and this is the one formula. So like this we can easily remember. Now this is completed. Now these two we will take, that is, if you take cos theta into secant theta, same way we are getting 1, because these two are also reciprocals to each other. R and R will get cancelled, and X and X will get cancelled. So that is also 1. Now cos theta is equal to 1/secant theta. Cos theta is equal to 1/secant theta. And secant theta means this will go to that side. So secant theta is equal to 1/cos theta. And also one more thing is there, that is tan and cot. That is also we will see. Tan theta into cot theta is equal to 1. Tan theta into cot theta is equal to 1. Tan theta is equal to, this cot will go to that side, then 1/cot theta. Tan theta is equal to 1/cot theta. And cot theta is equal to 1/tan theta. So these are the reciprocals to each other. Sin theta into cosecant theta is equal to 1, and cos theta into secant theta is equal to 1, and tan theta into cot theta is equal to 1. These are the most important formulas which we are going to remember. Now, two special formulas are there. Those are, see here, I am going to write sin theta I am taking. That sin theta I am dividing with cos theta. So sin theta means y/r. Cos theta means x/r. So rr will get cancelled, that is y/x. y/x means what? Y means opposite side, x means adjacent side. Opposite side by adjacent side, the basic concept we learn, that is tan theta. So tan theta is equal to, now I got sin theta by cos theta. Most very important, so many problems we are doing this formula. So tan theta is equal to sin theta by cos theta. Tan theta is equal to sin theta by cos theta. Same way, if I do cos theta by sin theta, cos theta by sin theta, again now I will get x by y, because r and r will get cancelled. X by y, x means adjacent side theta, and y means opposite side. Adjacent by opposite is cot theta, that is cot theta. So in our IIIT, so they don't give directly. So they will give like this. See here, this cot theta bring this side, then they will give like this. Tan theta into cos theta is equal to how much? So you have to remember, tan theta is equal to sin by cos means tan theta into cos theta is sin theta. Simply have to write sin. Otherwise, one more thing you can do, sin by cos you write, cos and cos will get cancelled. So answer is sin theta. So like this also we can do. So remember the basic concept, then you can easily do the problems. Next. So this ratios is completed and relations also completed. Next, values. Next, values. Now see here, 0 degrees, 30 degrees, 45 degrees, 60 degrees and 90 degrees. These are the values we have to find. So simply we are mug upping or we are by hearting. So simply I am going to say, see here, this is the radius. If the radius is making theta, that is, if the radius is close to x-axis, radius is close to x-axis, then so there is no y value, there is no y value. So y is equal to 0 and x is equal to x and r is equal to x, because radius is equal to r, radius is equal to r, and x value is x only and y value is 0. That those three only we have. Now we know very well. So theta is 0, so sine 0 is equal to what is the formula of y by r? Y value is 0, 0 by x, that is 0, that is 0. Sine 0 is 0. Next, cos 0. Cos 0 is x by r. So here x value is x only and r value is also x. X and x will get cancelled. So answer is 1. Answer is 1. Cos 0 is equal to 1. Next, tan 0. So tan 0 means y by x. So this is y by x. So y value is 0, 0 by x is 0. So tan 0 is also 0. Tan 0 also 0. So like this you have to remember. You should not by heart. So like this you have to remember. So the reciprocal of sine 0 is cosecant. So cosecant 0, that is equal to undefined or not defined, because 1 by 0. 1 by 0 is not defined, because cosecant theta we learned just now in the relations. Cosecant theta is equal to 1 by sin theta. So cosecant theta is equal to 1 by 0. 1 by 0 is not defined. Secant 0. Secant 0 is also 1, because 1 by 1. 1 by 1 means 1 only. Next, cot 0. So cot 0 is equal to not defined. Cot 0 is equal to not defined. So we got the values of all like this. So now I am going to write here. If you don't remember, so do this simply method. So 0, 30, 45, 60, 90. Yes, sine, cos, tan. So these three are enough, because the reciprocals you know very well. So here sine 0, 0, cos 0, 0, tan, cos 0, 1, tan 0, 0. This is remember. Now, I'm going to explain 30 degrees. Now I'm going to explain 30 degrees. How 30 degrees coming? Now see here, I'm going to consider equilateral triangle. I'm going to consider equilateral triangle. So that is A, B, C. So I'm drawing a perpendicular bisector. So means this is a 30 degrees. This is also 30 degrees. So this is a 90 degrees. This is a 90 degrees. This is 60 degrees. This is also 60 degrees. So see here, 60, 60, 60. So this is an equilateral triangle. I'm going to say this is a side A. This is also side A. So this is also side A. Now if you say this is A by 2, means half of the side. This is also A by 2, half of this side. Now I'm going to find, using this triangle only, I'm going to find sine 30 and sine 60 and cos 30, cos 60, tan 60 and tan 30. So these two I'm going to find. If this is A by T, if this is A, then the height will be, so root over, see, this is a hypotenuse square minus side square. So hypotenuse square is A square, so this is A square by 4. So if you find the square root, then 3A square by 4 means that is root 3 into A by 2. Root 3 into A by 2. So this is the root 3 by, root 3 by 2 into A. So using this Pythagoras theorem, hypotenuse square is equal to side square plus side square. Using, I got the height root 3 by 2 into A and side is A by 2. And if you take any triangle, this triangle or this triangle, so sine 30 I am going to find. Sine 30 is equal to, this is only 30, opposite side by hypotenuse. Opposite side is A by 2 and hypotenuse is, opposite side is A by 2 and hypotenuse is A by 1. So if you reciprocal, then a by 2 into 1 by a. So a and a will get cancelled. Answer is 1 by 2. So sin theta I am getting 1 by 2. Sin theta I am getting 1 by 2. Now cos 30. Cos 30 means adjacent side by hypotenuse. So root 3 by 2 into a by a. So a and a will get cancelled. So root 3 by 2. So cos 30 is root 3 by 2. Next, tan 30. So tan 30 if I find. So how I get tan 30? Opposite side by hypotenuse. Opposite side by adjacent side. So opposite side how much? A by 2. And adjacent side how much? Root 3 by 2. A by. So a and a will get cancelled. 2 and 2 will get cancelled. So 1 by root 3. So 1 by root 3 I am getting. So same as if you do 60s. Sin 60 if you do means opposite side by hypotenuse. A will get cancelled. So root 3 by 2. And this is 1 by 2 and this is root 3. So like this you will get. Next we are going to discuss about 45 degrees. So here 45 degrees means we have to take right angle triangle. So those are equal sides. This is a and this is a. This is root 2 into a. This is root 2 into a. So these are the isosceles right angle triangle. So this is a 45, 90 and 45. If you take this triangle, you can get easily sine 45. Opposite side by hypotenuse. Opposite side how much? A. Hypotenuse how much? Root 2 A. A will get cancelled. So 1 by root 2. So 1 by root 2 is the answer. Again, so if you find cos 45 also, that is also opposite side by hypotenuse, adjacent side by hypotenuse. So a by root 2 a cancel, that is 1 by root 2. So this is also 1 by root 2. Next if you find tan 45, opposite side by adjacent side. So a cancel, answer 1, is also 1. So only if you find 90 degrees then the table is finished. The reciprocals also in very well, all are 1 by 1 by 1 by like that. So you will get a reciprocals also. Now we'll see. Now on the same diagram, if the radius is close to y, if the radius is close to y, then what happen? Y is equal to y and x, there is no x value and there is r value is equal to y. So here r is equal to y is equal to y and x is not there, because x is not there. If it is perpendicular distance, then so x is there. There is no x value. So here y is equal to y and r is equal to y. R is equal to y and x is equal to 0. Now sin 90 degrees, because here radius and this is 90 degrees. Sin 90 degrees is equal to y by r. So here y value is y only, r value is y only. So y is means 1. So sin 90 is equal to 1. Sin 90 is equal to 1. Next, cos 90. Cos 90 means x by r, x value is 0, 0 by y, that is equal to 0. So cos 0 is equal to 0. Next, tan 90. So tan 90 means y by x. So y value is y, x value is 0. So not defined. So tan 90 is not defined. So like this we can find the values of the trigonometric values. Next, some special values are also there. We have to learn those are also. That is 15 degrees, 18 degrees, 36 degrees, 54 degrees. See here, 15 degrees, 18 degrees, 36 degrees, 54 degrees. See here, sin 15 is, we can say sin 45 minus sin 30. So like this if you do, then you will get root 3 minus 1 by 2 root 2. Root 3 minus 1 by 2 root 2. So sin 18 means, then pause here. Pause here. Okay, values completed. Next, identities. So identities are most very important. There are in trigonometry three identities are there. So before going to discuss about this is the algebraic identity, because for any value of a and b this is satisfied. For example, if you take a1 and b2, then 1 plus 2 whole square is equal to 1 square plus 2 into 1 into 2 plus 2 square. So that means 1 plus 4 plus 4, that is equal to 9.
Here 1 plus 2 is 3, 3 square means 9, 9 is equal to 9.
For any value of a and b, it is satisfying. In the same way, for any value of theta, the equations are becomes true, then the equations are called trigonometric identities. Here most very important formulas are there. So listen very well. Sine square theta plus cos square theta is equal to, I don't know. You also don't know. Let us suppose sine square theta plus cos square theta is equal to, we don't know. But we have to find. Now see here, sine square theta means y square by r square. Cos square means just no basic formula. Here cos square means x square by r square. So if you take LCM common, then y square plus x square by r square. So using this, the basic fundamental, this is r, this is x, this is y, this is x. We know where hypotenuse square is called psi square plus psi square. So that means this can be written as r square by r square. So r square will get cancelled. So answer is equal to 1. So sin square theta plus cos square theta is equal to 1. So like this you have to learn, then you won't forget. Now I got the answer, sin square theta plus cos square theta is equal to 1. Now we know even the basic fundamental transformation of the formulas. Plus will go to that side means that is minus. Minus will go to that side means that is plus. Multiplication is going that side means division. Division is going that side means that is multiplication. Using this formula, we know very well sin square theta is equal to 1 minus cos square theta. Now square is going that side means that is under root. So square root, then we can say that sin theta is equal to root over 1 minus cos square theta. In the same way, if I bring this term to that side, then cos square theta is equal to 1 minus sin square theta. Square is going that side means cos theta is equal to root over 1 minus sin square theta. So in exam they may ask anything. If root over 1 minus sin square theta is equal to which of the following? Sin theta, cos theta, tan theta, cot theta. What we have to write? We have to write cos theta. So like that we have to learn. Now this is the first identity, first basic identity. Now the second basic identity, that is secant square theta minus tan square theta. If you do the same process what we have done this one, you will get answer 1 only. Secant square theta minus tan square theta is equal to 1. Then this minus tan square theta I want to bring to that side. Then it will becomes positive. Then we can say that secant square theta is equal to 1 plus tan square theta. Now square I am bringing to that side, then it is becoming root. Then secant theta is equal to root over 1 plus tan square theta. Now I want only tan square theta, so this one I don't want, so this one bring to this side, then what happens? Tan square theta is equal to secant square theta minus 1. I don't want this one, so I want to bring this one to this side, then tan square theta is equal to secant square theta minus 1. No, I don't want this square, I want only tan, then what can say? Tan theta is equal to root over secant square theta minus 1. Now clearly if you observe, this is a and this is b, a square minus b square is equal to 1. One more formula is there. This is also identity. A square minus b square is equal to 1 means we know very well a plus b into a minus b. See here we can say that a plus b into a minus b. If a plus b into a minus b is equal to 1 means a plus b is equal to 1 by a minus b and a minus b is equal to 1 by a plus b. In the same like that, this is a and this is b, then we can say that secant theta plus tan theta into secant theta minus tan theta, that is equal to 1. Secant theta plus tan theta into secant theta minus tan theta is equal to 1. Now secant theta plus tan theta I want, then what happened? This is going that side, then 1 by secant theta minus tan theta. Same like that, secant theta minus tan theta is equal to 1 by secant theta plus tan theta. So these are the most very important formulas. And third identity is also there, the remaining sine and cos relation we have seen, secant and tan relation we have seen. Now we are going to see cosecant theta and cot theta, that is same like this only, cosecant square theta minus cot square theta is equal to 1. Using this identity, we are making again, these are all formulas. See, cosecant square theta is equal to 1 plus cot square theta, cosecant theta is equal to root over 1 plus cot square theta, cot square theta is equal to cosecant square theta minus 1, cot theta is equal to root over cosecant square theta minus 1, cosecant theta plus cot theta into cosecant theta minus cot is equal to 1, cosecant theta plus cot is equal to 1 by cosecant theta minus cot theta, cosecant theta minus cot is equal to 1 by cosecant theta plus cot theta. So these are all formulas same, just I have said, but I didn't write because these are also same like this only. So successfully we completed identities. These are all formulas you have to remember like me, isn't it? Now special cases are there, those we will see now. What are the special angles? Special angles are there means whatever the angle you give, I will say the answer. So that is the type of this special angles. For this purpose, I am going to take x axis, I am going to take y axis. This x axis and y axis are meeting at origin. So this is called 90 degrees. What I have drawn, that is 90 degrees. If you go front, that is 90 plus. This is what? 90 plus theta. This portion is 90 plus theta. Means it may be 110 degrees or 100 degrees or 130 degrees. It may be anything. If you go back, if you come back, then this portion is 90 minus theta. 90 minus theta. Again, from here to here, this is 180 because this is a straight angle. If you go back, this is 180 minus theta. This total portion is 180 minus theta means 170. This is 90 plus, 90 plus means 170. 180 minus also 170. From going front, this is 180 plus theta. 180 plus theta portion. From up to here, 270 degrees. If you come back, then this is 270 minus theta. 270 minus theta. Go front means this is 270 plus theta. This is a complete angle, so 360. Come back means 360 minus theta, and this is a 360 plus theta. So this is the, they may give the problem like this. So 270 minus theta is which quadrant? So 270 minus theta is a third quadrant. You have to remember. 180 minus theta is which quadrant? 180 minus theta is a second quadrant. So like this they may give. So remember only one thing. This is a 190, 290s, 390s, 490s. So that is remember, simple. 190, 290, 390, 490. Again, 590s, 690s, 790s, 890s. 1090s, 1190s, 1290s, 1390s, like that you remember, isn't it? So now I am going to explain the most very important concept. In the first quadrant, all are positive, all are positive, all values are positive. According to, we are learning special angles. See here, I have written ASTS, ASTC. All sine, cos, tan, cosecant, secant, cot, whatever the angle you are coming, everything is positive. So example, see there, 90, below 90. Below 90 means sine 0, sine 30, sine 45, sine 60, sine 90, or cos 30, cos 60. So what are the values? The table is all having, all are positive. There is no negative value. But you don't know, trigonometric ratios are having negative values also. So we will see now. Here is coming to here, this is sine and cosecant. This sine theta and cosecant theta only positive, the remaining are all negative, means cos negative and tan negative and cot negative and secant negative. Whereas coming to here, see here S, all S. Next here T, this is a T, means tan theta and cot theta. This only positive, tan theta and cot theta. See here. Here C means cos and secant. This only positive. The remaining all negative. What sir, this is we are not understanding means. I will give the example, then you can easily understand. All silver tea cups. You can remember. All students of 10th class. All Sri Chaitanya Techno Campuses. All smart teaching classes. Means me. So, like this you can say. Now, I am going to explain. See here. I want sine 135 degrees. So, this can be written as sine 90 plus 45 degrees. Sine 90 plus 45. 90 plus 45 how much? 135. See here. Sine 90 plus 45 means sine basic is 1. So, before going to discuss about this one, I will give the two formulas. So, you remember, then we are going to discuss 135. See here, n into 90 degrees plus or minus theta is equal to sine theta and is equal to cos theta. See here, If n is even number, here n is even means sin theta will come. If n is odd number, cos theta will come. If n is odd number. Once again, I am repeating. n into 90 degrees plus or minus theta is equal to sin theta. If n is even number means 180 degrees, 360 degrees. So, like this, it means sin will come. If n is odd number means you will get cos means sine will get cos will get sine, tan will get cot will get tan, and cosecant will get secant will get cosecant. Now see here, now I'll explain sine 135. This can be written as sine 1 into 90 plus 45. See here, according to formula, n value odd number means sine will get cos, theta means what here? 45. Now, here plus or minus you have to see. See here, sine 90 plus. Up to here 90 plus in the second quadrant. Second quadrant sine will get plus only. So, that means plus 1 by root 2. Here cos 45 is 1 by root 2. So, sine 135 degrees is also 1 by root 2 will get answer. The same problem only we will do like this. 180 minus 45. So, sine 180 minus 45. This 180 can be written as sine 2 into 90 minus 45. So, see here, 2 is even number. If n is even number, then sine only will get sine 45. See here, 290 is minus. Here 190, 290 is minus. That is the second quadrant. The second quadrant sine plus only. So, that is 1 by root 2. So, if you do like this also 1 by root 2, if you do like this also 1 by 2. So, one more example I will give, then you are very clearly understand. See here, tan 390 degrees. I want tan 390 degrees. This can be written as tan 360 degrees plus 30 degrees, isn't it? So, tan 360 degrees can be written as 4 into 90 degrees plus 30 degrees. Here 4 is even number, so tan 30 only come. If it is odd number, cot 30 will come. So, tan 30. Now, 490 is plus. 190, 290, 390, 490 is plus. So, in the plus means first quadrant, all are positive. So, tan 30 is equal to 1 by root 3. So, means tan 390 degrees is 1 by root 3. The same problem can be written as tan 450 degrees minus 60 degrees, isn't it? Now, this can be written as tan 590 is a 450 minus 60. Any value you have to write 90 multiples.
So 5 is odd number. If it is odd number, means 10 will get cot. So cot 60 degrees. So 590 is minus 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 90 is minus first quadrant. So plus only. All are plus only. Means 1 by root 3. Cot 60 how much? 1 by root 3. So like this, any value you will get special angles. Any special angle you can find. So we completed special angles. Next, converts and extra formulas and triplets. These three, if you complete, means so our concept is completed. Next, we are going to discuss about converts. What is converts? Express tan in terms of sine, they will ask. So express tan theta in terms of sine theta. See, tan theta means what? Sin theta by cos theta, isn't it? But they want only in terms of sin. Now this can be written as sin theta by cos theta in terms of sin. You know, so sin square theta plus cos square theta equal to 1, then cos square theta is equal to 1 minus sin square theta, then cos theta is equal to root over 1 minus sin square theta. So root over 1 minus sin square theta is the answer. So like this, they can ask any conversions. So you give anything, I will convert the problem. So for example, now we'll take cos and cosecant. Cos and cosecant. So these are the unknown values. So now cos theta is equal to 1 by secant theta. Isn't it? Otherwise, cos theta is equal to root over 1 minus sin square theta. Isn't it? Cos theta is equal to root over, but we want cos theta in terms of cosecant theta. Now root over 1 minus this sin square theta can be written as 1 by cosecant square theta. So this is the answer. We can say 1 minus 1 by cosecant square theta, or otherwise root over cosecant square theta minus 1 by cosecant square theta. See, cos theta we are expressing in terms of cosecant square theta. So like this we are converting. So this conversion also completed. Now extra formulas. So extra formulas are there in trigonometry. We have to learn. Those are multiples, we can say, or sub multiples, we can say. Means, see here, sine 2a, we have to learn. Sine 2a means this 2 coming up, then 2 sin a cos a. 2 sin a cos a. This is the formula we have to remember. So they may ask, they will give this one. Which of the following is true? Which of the following is true? Four options they will give. Four formulas, extra formulas they will give. You have to remember. Then you can easily find the answer. Then sin 2a is one more formula is there. 2 tan a by 1 plus tan square a. So 2 tan a by 1 plus tan square a. Next, cos 2a. So cos 2a is a Brahma of the trigonometry. So it is having four formulas. So first formula is this 2 is becoming square, then means cos square a minus sin square a, and 2 cos square a minus 1. 2 cos square a minus 1. Next, 1 minus 2 sin square a and 1 minus tan square a by 1 plus tan square a. 1 minus tan square a by 1 plus tan square. These four are the cos 2a formulas, Brahma of the trigonometry. Next, tan 2a. Tan 2a. So we know very well sin 2a by cos 2a. So 2 tan a by 1 minus tan square a. 1 minus tan square a. These are the three important formulas for trigonometry. So extra formulas. Still so many formulas are there. So I will give in the exam, in the grand test. So you will learn grand test. In the grand test, I will explain each and everything, the all formulas. Next, Pythagoras triplets. So I am giving the shortcut for Pythagoras triplet, that is n square comma n square minus 1 comma n square plus 1. So I am giving the formula 2m comma m square minus 1 comma m square plus 1. So if you substitute any value, for example, if you take 2, so 2 2s are 4, 2 square minus 1, 3, 2 square plus 1, 5. So 3, 4, 5 are the Pythagoras theorems. If you take 4, 4 2s are 8, 4 square minus 1, so 15, 4 square plus 1, 17. So 8, 15, 17 are Pythagoras theorems. So like that we can say, otherwise, n square comma n square minus 1 by 2, n square plus 1 by 2. So n square comma n square n comma n square minus 1 by 2 n square plus 1 by 2. So n value means 3 if you take, then 3 square minus 1, so 8 by 2, that is 4, then so 3 square plus 1, 10 by 2, that is equal to 5. So 3, 4, 5, those are the Pythagorean theorems. If n value is odd number, we have to take this one. If 2m value is even number, we have to take this one. If n value is odd number, we have to take this one. If m value, 2m value is even number, we have to take this one. So these are the trigonometric concept, most very important. I think you understand very well. So if you like this video, please just give it in comment box. So excellent teaching or super teaching. So I like this teaching. Like this, compliments and compliments give me. So and tomorrow I will explain the top 15 models. So thank you very much. If you like this video, just like it. If you want to share it, you can share it. Thank you very much. Bye bye.